The Catholic Church and its parishioners are very much a part of our Indian society, and therefore whatever happens in our country, be it political or social, affects each one of us. But what has been the response of the Church to these situations? What do the youth feel about it? Let's find out on this episode of Youth Talk. Welcome to this new episode of Youth Talk. Our topic for today is, should the church be getting involved in socio-political issues? To help us discuss this topic, we have with us Marshall and Nicole. Guys, could you please introduce yourselves, beginning with Nicole?
Hi, I'm Nicole Coutinho, and I'm from Immaculate Conception Church, Borivali. I'm currently pursuing my master's in social work from College of Social Work, Nirmala Niketan. And I'm also a fitness coach at Clinetics. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicole. Marshall?
Hi, this is Marshall from Our Lady of Lourdes Sion. I'm currently working as a city manager in a logistic company. Thank you.
Hi, thank you, Nicole and Marshall, for joining us. So let's begin with you, Nicole. What are these socio-political issues that you feel are affecting our country? And have you seen the church take an active role, an active part in these issues?
Okay. So for me, the social political issues that I know about are the anti-CAA and NRC, the farmers movement, disability movement, anti-corruption movement, and also the Me Too and queer movement. From these, there are also movements wherein comedians and journalists speaking about social political issues are held back for what they say. In this, I found that when the issue of Father Stan being held was very clearly addressed by the church, and I found the involvement of the church a lot during that issue.
Okay. Marshall, what do you feel?
I think most of the points in most of the social political issues Nicole has covered. I would like to stick to CAA, NRC, the recent going on farmers bill, as well as I like to add on the demonetization, which was heavily impacted on the common people, right? And to speak about the church, I haven't seen the church being involved so strongly coming inside all these issues.
Right. So even I personally feel that it was only when Father Stan was arrested, we actually began to see, you know, the face of the church. You could see priests and nuns who were on the street, you know, protesting. But otherwise, even for me personally, it was kind of absent. You know, don't really see them out on the streets that much. So in your personal opinion, Marshall, let's begin with you. What do you feel about priests and nuns being actively involved in social political issues, for example, speaking during the homily or speaking at some other times about all these issues? What do you feel about it?
Rather, my feeling about this issue is that I do feel that the priest should not be coming up and openly speaking in public about social political issues. What I believe is that as a church, as a congregation, we should have a different body where people can appoint a leader and he can become a spokesperson on behalf of the church to speak about all these things.
Okay. So, Marshall, you are not so much in favor of priests and nuns being directly involved in speaking about it.
Right.
Nicole, what do you feel?
So, I would like to say that I would like when the priests and nuns would address such issues, but because that is the first step to acquiring knowledge about such issues and also knowing what is the church stand on such social political issues. So once it is addressed, for example, I would go back to Father Stan's example. When it was addressed during the sermon, the congregation actually got involved and then would check the updates. When is the bail? When is the... They would go back and actively participate on the next steps regarding that case. So I feel that knowing about the case and the following about it is the first step is to get knowledge about it. When it's communicated, there's more participation by the congregation.
Okay. So, Marshall, what do you feel are the different ways then in which the church can get involved? Because see, these are issues which, you know, practically affect everybody, right? So if the priest is not speaking about it, if the nuns are not speaking about it, how else can the church make an impact? What do you feel? And especially, what about youth? You know, what do they do?
Right. So brother, as I already told you that I would like to see a community getting formed, a body getting formed, which talks about, which discusses about all these social political issues in the church. Definitely, yes, the father can come and just address it. But as a spokesperson, there should be somebody else. There can be different ways we can teach people about the history, about each party and each political community, from where the roots are. We can have various discussions going on. We can educate people about the right source of information, make YouTube channels and spread awareness. I think these are the way, different ways where we can educate and spread information amongst our community.
Nicole, anything else that you would like to add to the different ways that Marshall has mentioned?
So, like Marshall, I have three points that I would like to suggest. So, initially, first, in which such political issues are openly spoken about and people know what is happening, it may be a priest or a person from the congregation actually imparting this information. Second point would be inclusion in sermons, wherein the people actually get to know from the priest about their views and in accordance the values and stands of the church according to it. And the third point would be the parishioners who are involved in such situations and such socio-political issues, making them known to the parishioners, the rest of the parishioners, so that even if we don't have a platform, they know who to go to in case they have such queries.
Okay. Marshall, coming back to you, while we try to summarize this topic, what are the two major pros and cons that you feel of the church, you know, getting actively involved in socio-political issues? So what happens if we actually do get involved, and what else if we don't? So what do you feel?
Right, brother. So the positive, there are definitely positives and negatives out here. To say the positive things, yes, definitely as a community we'll get visibility because we'll be speaking and we as people will be vocal about it. And with visibility, we will be getting a lot of strength inside the community, right? And the disadvantages is that we would be inviting a lot of trouble within the community, which I feel is not required as of now. So this is what I have.
So Nicole, Marshall has his reservations about the trouble which the visibility will bring up. What do you feel?
So according to me, I feel that once we start speaking and getting involved in socio-political issues, the pros of it would be the ethical standards of the church would be made known and people would know what is the church stand and values behind it. And the second would be the integrity of the entire church involvement in such socio-political issues. On the flip side of the coin, a negative that would arise would be there would be threats. Because in the current governing system, there would be threats to the us as a minority. And the second thing that would arise due to the threats is restriction. So there would be increased amount of restriction that would curb the freedom that we enjoy.
Okay. So thank you, Marshall and Nicole, for being frank and sharing your ideas and views about this topic. Now, for me personally, it is a very difficult call for us and for the church leaders to make. Because as you all have rightly mentioned, it will give us visibility, but it also attract a lot of a lot of troubles and tensions which will come our way. But at the same time, we really need to think as a church, what would Jesus do if he were in this situation today? Would he stay quiet or would he speak up? Would he be out in the streets protesting against these kind of atrocities which are happening, or would he not? So that is for all of us to reflect over and answer. And so again, guys, thank you very much for joining us, and I wish you all the very best in your lives in the future. And I really continue praying for you that you may be an active part in the church that you are in, and continue to make a difference also in the society that you are living in. All right, so thank you very much and all the very best.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, Nicole.
Thanks, brother. Thanks, Marshall.
You have heard the various point of views from which this issue can be looked at, and I'm sure you would have realized that it is not such an easy decision to make. What do you personally feel about it? Should the church be more involved in the socio-political issues? Do let us know in the comment section below. See you soon for another episode of Youth Talk. Take care. Bye-bye.